So today is the last session on this topic, three-dimensional geometry. So this is the lecture 7, last session. We discussed in the previous class up to 37 questions. Today the next question is, the question is equation of line. Equation of line passing through equation of line passing through 1, 1, 1 and perpendicular to 2x plus 3y plus z equal to 5 is. This is the question. So children, this is the question. Here it is asking equation of the line. This line is passing through one point 1, 1. And this line is perpendicular to this plane. This line is perpendicular to this plane. So we know it in the previous classes we discussed. If a line is perpendicular to the plane, then they are in proportion. So if line means L, assume that if line is perpendicular to plane means pi. If a line is perpendicular to the plane, then they are in the proportion. Proportion is nothing but the meaning of proportion. Whatever the plane DRS are nothing but DRS of the line. That's it. That is the concept here. So children, if a line perpendicular to the plane is nothing but the DRS of the plane is nothing but DRS of the line. So we know it, equation of a line formula. So what is the equation of a line formula? Equation of line. The formula is x minus x1 by a equal to y minus y1 by b equal to z minus z always. So here these are x1, y1, z1. This is the passing point. And then what about the ABCs? ABC is nothing but the DRS of the plane. So what is the DRS of plane? X is the a equal to 2, b equal to 3, and c equal to 1. So if you put here, x minus x1 means 1, y a means 2, y minus y1 by, y1 means 1, y b means 3, z minus z1 by, c means 1. So what is the equation of a plane? The equation of a line which is passing through 1, 1, 1 and perpendicular to the plane. Passing point x1, y1, z1, line perpendicular to the plane is nothing but whatever the plane DRS of there, that only DRS of the line. So if you substitute it, this is the equation of a line. Now, next question. Next question is the plane AX plus BY plus CZ equal to 1. This is a plane. Meets the coordinate axis in A comma B comma C. Then the centroid of the triangle is, this is the question. So students, he is telling that one, the plane AX plus BY plus CZ equal to 1. It is meets the coordinate axis at ABC. Then he is asking the centroid. So plane means there is no particular shape. So here I am going to draw the diagram. Assume that this is the coordinate axis. So this one you take it as x axis, y axis, z axis. One plane. Plane means there is no particular shape. So it is intersecting the coordinate axis. I am going to take the plane is like a triangle shape. So this is a plane which intersects the x axis at A, y axis at B, and z axis at X. So this is the plane which intersects xyz axis at ABC. So it is intersecting x axis. Where it is intersecting, we don't know. So first of all, we will take the plane equation. What is the plane equation given? AX plus BY plus CZ equal to. First of all, this plane equation, you convert it to the intercept form.
What is the intercept form of a plane? The intercept form of a plane is x by a plus 5 by b plus 10 by c equal to 1. This is the intercept form of a plane. Means this plane equation to convert into this form. How to convert that? Here, x coefficient. What is the x coefficient? A is there. This one we can write in this form. X by 1 by a. And this one is the y by 1 by b. And this one I am writing z by 1 by c is equal to 1. Why I written like this? Because of that y below y. Y below y, if we write this reciprocal, then it is converted as ax. And this is the by. And this one is the cz. Means this ax plus dy plus cz equal to 1, we can convert into the form of x by 1 by a, y by 1 by b, z by 1 by c is equal to 1. So we are converting in the form. Now this is the x intercept. Why? Because y below y right is reciprocal ax. And this is the by, this is cz. So the x intercept means it is intersecting x axis at 1 by a. Intersecting x axis means only x is there. Y and z both are zero. Intersecting y axis means only y is there. What is the y intercept to 1 by b? Comma 0. Intersecting z axis means only z is there. So it is the boundary. Now he is asking the centroid of the triangle. Now this is the plane which is the shape of a triangle. Now he is asking centroid. We know the centroid of the triangle from the x1, y1, z1. This is the x2, y2, z2. And this is the x3, y3, z. So we know the centroid formula. What is the centroid formula? Centroid formula is x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3 in the same way y1 plus y2 plus y2 by 3, z1 plus z2 plus z3. That is the centroid formula. So here x1 means 1 by a, x2 means 0, x3 means 0. Means 1 by a plus 0 plus 0 is nothing but 1 by a only. 1 by a by the same manner, y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3. 0 plus 1 by 3 plus 0 means 1 by 3 by 3, 1 by c by 3. This is the set. Then we can write this value like this: 1 by 3 into a, 3a. 1 by 3a, 1 by 3b, 1 by 3c. So what is the centroid of this plane which intersects the coordinate axis at a, b, c? Then this plane is in the shape of a triangle. So this is the x intercept, y intercept, z intercept. Then the centroid formula is x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3, y1 plus y2 plus y2 by 3, z1 plus z2 plus z3 by 3. If you substitute it, we get the answer. The centroid of a triangle is 1 by 3a, comma 1 by 3b, comma 1 by 3c. This way. Now we'll go to the next question. Today is the last session to complete this three-dimensional geometry. Two lines. He given two lines are given. What are the two lines here? The two lines x equal to ay plus b, comma z equal to cy plus b. This is one line A. And another line he given x equal to a dash y plus b dash, comma next one is the z equal to c dash y plus b dash. Will be perpendicular. Will be perpendicular. If and only if, this is the question. If and only if. He given some conditions and given. I am going to explain the conditions. Student, here two lines are given. Here what are the two lines? This one is one line and this side, this one is another line. So here two lines are given and he said that one, these two lines are perpendicular. Here what is the condition? So first of all, line equation. Generally what is the line equation? Line equation means x minus x1 by a equal to y minus y1 by b equal to z minus z. This is the general form of Cartesian equation of a line. Means now to x one side, y inside, that is the position. So here ay plus b is there and converting. First of all, this constant I am setting this side. Means x minus b equal y into a also in same this side, then it is converted as x minus b by a is equal to 1. In the same manner, here also, from this also we can find the y line. What is that one? Z minus d equal to cy. See, you send this side. Z minus d by c equal to y. Student, if you observe, this is also y, this one also y. These two are equal, y. Then these two also compulsory equal. Because here y. If these two are equal, these two also equal. Means finally, the line equation is x minus b by a is equal to y is equal to what is the y value? Z minus d by c. Finally, this one I converted into this one. This is the equation of a plane line. Sorry, this is the equation of a line. Converting, t given subtract, subtract, I made it like a one line equation. So, this is the line equation and nothing is there, means denominator 1. In the same manner, here also, if you find the y value plus b dash, if you set this side, x minus b dash is equal to a dash 1 into a dash also, you set that side, x minus b dash by a dash equal to. In the same manner, here also, z minus b dash equal to c dash 1 into c dash, if you set that, z minus b dash by c dash equal to 1. Here also y, here also y, these two are equal, definitely these two also equal. Means finally, you can write this one also like a line equation, x minus b dash by a dash equal to y equal to z minus b dash by c dash. Nothing is done, means but. Now, finally we got a two line equation. This is the one line, this is the another line. He said that one, these two lines are perpendicular. He said these two lines are perpendicular. Perpendicular means when two lines are perpendicular, then product of their DRS is equal to 0. Sum of product of their DRS means this line DRS is A and here this one is A dash. The product of these two means A, A dash. Again here 1 into 1 is nothing but 1. And here C dash plus C into C dash is equal to when two lines are perpendicular. Otherwise, we can write like this also. If you want to convert into the vector form, this is called V1 vector. V1 vector is nothing but the DRS of the first line. What is the first line DRS? A I cap. Here nothing is there, means by 1 is there. 1 J cap. And this is the C K cap. This is the first line DRS. Next, for the second line also, V2 vector equal to A dash I cap and here V value is 1 J cap and that value is the C dash K. Now, he said these two lines are perpendicular, means then the dot product of these two lines equal to 0. Then the dot product of these two lines means V1 vector dot V2 vector compulsory 0. So, the dot product of these two means A into A dash, A into A dash plus 1 ones are 1. C into C dash is equal to 0. So what is the condition? A dash plus 1 plus C C dash equal to 0. This is the condition. Okay, that's it. Now, one more time, this is a very important term. So many times asked me in the question in the exam, in the compared to JEE mains, first from this you find out y value, from this you find out y value. When these two y values are equal, then these two values are so equal. Make it convert this one into the line equation. In the same way, then we can write the V1 vector as DRS of first line, V2 vector as DRS of the second line. Then we will do this two dot product equal to 0. Why? Because of that these two lines are perpendicular, means then their dot product equal to 0. Then the dot product means this one V1, V2, if you did the dot product, then the condition is A dash plus C dash plus 1 equal to 0. This is the condition. Now, we will go to the next question. The line x minus 4.1 is equal to y minus 2 by 1 equal to z minus k by 2 lies exactly on the plane2x minus 4y plus z equal to 7, then the value of a, then the value of k is, this is the question. So children, here if you observe, this is the line which is lies exactly on the plane, means this line is on this plane. He is asking then find the value of k. Already in the previous class we discussed, if a line is lies on a plane, means the line and plane both are also passing through the same point. If the line and plane both are passing through the same point, then we can say that what the line is lies on a plane. So what is the line? This is the line passing point. What is the line passing point? 4, 2, k. This is the passing point of the line. So the given line is passing through, it is passing through which point? The given line is passing through, the point is 4 comma 2 comma k. This is line passing through this point, 4 comma 2 comma k. Now, this 4 comma 2 comma k, you substitute in the given plane. In the place of x, write down 4, in the place of y, write down 2, in the place of z, write down k. If you substitute it, because of this line lies on the plane, is this passing point, that passing point both are same. So if you substitute it in the place of x 4, assume that this is x, this is y, this is z. If you substitute it, 2 into 4 minus 4 into 2, and that is in the place of z vector k equal to 7. 2 4s are 8, minus 4 2s are 8, plus k equal to 7. Minus 10 plus k cancel. What is the k value? The value of a is 7. So children, passing exactly lies means through which point it is passing, same point lies on the plane also. So passing, divide the general form of a straight line is x minus x1 by a equal to y minus y1 by b equal to z minus z1 by c. Means this is the line which is passing through the point x1, y1, z1. Like 4 comma 2 comma k. And we have to substitute. That's it. This is the answer. Now the next question is,
assume that two planes, these two are parallel. Why these two are parallel? X, Y, Z,
distance as same. Then what is the parallel distance from the distance of this modulus? So mod of d1 minus d2 by square root of a square plus b square plus c square. This is the formula for the perpendicular. This is the parallel, two parallel planes are there, right? So distance between two parallel planes formula is mod of d1 minus d2 by square root of a square plus b square plus c square. So if you will use this the same formula here, mod of d1 is minus 60, minus d2 is nothing but 5 by square root of a square. A square means 4 square. Next b square means 2 square. Next c square means 4 square. Okay, Chana? So using this formula, d1 means minus 60, minus d2 means 5 by square root of a square plus b square plus c square. After simplification, minus 60 minus 5 minus 21 in modulus minus 21 converted as plus 2. If we simplify this one, 4 square is 16 plus 16, 32. 32 plus 4 is 36. So the answer is 21 by 6. We can cancel it in three tables. 3 sevens are 3 twos are. So what is the distance between two parallel planes? Is 7 by 2 is the answer. That's it. And this is the answer. Now, we will go to the next question. Student, this is the important. This model is not in our textbook, but it is there in JEE Mains questions. JEE Mains syllabus is there. So be careful this one. Now the next question. Angle between, next question is angle between the lines. Angle between the lines 2x is equal to 3y is equal to minus z and 6x is equal to minus y is equal to minus 4z is. These are just now we did the same model. So 2x and 3y minus z, this one is there. He is asking angle between these two lines. Line means compulsory x, y, z coefficient always plus 1. That is a very important point. So converting this one into the line equation, standard form of the line. 2x, we can write like this, x by 1 by 2. Because of that, x, y, z coefficients always we need 1. Because what is the general standard form of the line? X minus x1 by a equal to y minus y1 by b equal to z minus z1 by c. This is the standard form. Means x, y, z coefficient always 1 by 1. So in x coefficient 2, this 2 we can write as x by 1 by 2 is equal to, you can write this formula. Equal to this 3y is there. This 3y also we can write as a y by 1 by 3 is equal to z by minus 1. X, y, z coefficient plus 1 we want. In the same manner, this one also if we converted x by 1 by 6 is equal to y by minus 1. Y by minus 1 is equal to z by minus 1 by 4. This is the z by minus 1 by 4. Why? Because of that 1 by 6, y below y, right it's reciprocal converted as 6x. This 4 also 4z. Okay. Now, he is asking angle between these two lines. Angle between these two lines means first we multiply. You can write this is as a b1 vector. So b1 vector equal to 1 by 2 I cap plus 1 by 3 j cap minus k cap. And b2 vector, what is the b2 vector? B2 vector is 1 by 6 I cap minus j cap minus 1 by 4 k. Now, first of all, angle between means we know it. First we find out the dot product of this two. Because of that, angle between our two lines formula is there. So what is the formula? Cos theta equal to b1 vector dot b2 vector by mod of b1 vector into mod of b2 vector. Actually, this is the angle between two lines formula. So to find this one, first we have to find b1 dot b2. Dot product is nothing but I component into I component. So 1 by 6 2 z plus into minus minus 1 by 3 minus into minus plus 1 by 4. Here the LCM, what is the LCM? 1 is the LCM. So here is there 3 4 times and 4 3 times. So we can write 3 plus 1 is the 4, 4 minus 4 is the 0. So student, the dot product of two vectors equal to 0. Compulsory, they are perpendicular. So what is the meaning here? V1 is perpendicular. between these two lines. What is the angle between these two lines? Angle between these two lines are 90 degrees. So what is the final answer? The final answer is angle between these two lines are 90 degrees. 90 degrees means 5 by 2 are 90. Yes. Okay. Next question. We'll go to the next question.
Passing through a given point 2 comma
of a plane, positive point actually what formula is there? Equation of a plane passing through, this is the formula we have in the textbook. Equation of a plane passing through x1, y1, z1 and a, b, c. These are drs. Drs is one formula is there. Equation of a plane, it is possible x1, y1, z1 and it has the drs abc. Is what is the formula? A into x minus x1 plus b into y minus y1 plus c into z minus z1 equal to 0. This is the formula. So here passing point is given. What is the passing point? 2 comma 3 comma 4. This is the passing point. So this passing point we can take as x1, y1, z1. Then sir, what about the abc? Abc is nothing but this line dr is only drs of the plane. Because the line is perpendicular to the plane. If the line is perpendicular to the plane, then the plane and line drs are same. The line and plane both drs are same. Why the line and plane both drs are same? Because the line is perpendicular to the plane. So we got it. This drs means this is the A, this one is the B, this one is the C. ABC values we got it, x1, y1, z1, values. We will put this one, A plus 1 you put x minus x1 means 2 and B value is the 2 into y minus y1, y1 means 3 and C value is 3, z minus z1 means 4 equal to 0. If you multiply, if you do this multiplication, 1 into x1, x minus 2, 2 into y, 2y, 2, 3 is 6, 3 into z, 3z, 3, 4z, 12 equal to 0. That means if we can write in order, x plus 2y plus 3z and here minus 12, minus 6, minus 3 is nothing but minus 20 equal to 0. This is the equation of a plane which is passing through the point 2, comma 3, comma 4 and perpendicular to the line. One more time. Passing point x1, y1, z1 and this line is perpendicular to the plane means this line dr is only plane dr. That's it children. So these are the important bits on this concept three-dimensional geometry. So we finished this three-dimensional geometry. In the next class we will start new topic. Thank you. Thank you.